Good morning students, welcome to e-learning class. This is your computer period and I am your computer teacher. So students, now open your book page number 17. Today we continue some more points of lesson number 2. Lesson name is parts of a computer. So open your book. Let's start our explanation part. Students, I hope you all have opened your computer book page number 17. So today we continue some more topics and lesson number 2. Okay, and lesson name is parts of a computer. So now we start headphone and microphone. Headphones are used when a single person wants to hear with sound or music. They are plugged into the computer through wires or a wireless. A microphone is used to record different sounds and your voice into a computer. So I hope you all have seen headphone or microphone. Look the picture here. This is a headphone, okay, and this is microphone. Is that clear? So headphone is used, a single person will use the headphone for hearing a sound or music. They are plugged into the computer through with wire. Is that clear? I hope you all know wire. Yesterday we have shown you a wire. So I hope you all have know very well wire. Here this is a wireless. Wireless means without wire. Okay. Some headphones or microphone is a wire and most of them are wireless. Both the headphones are come. A microphone is used to record different sounds and your voice into a computer. A wire phone is used to record the different sounds, okay, and your voice into the computer. Is that clear? I hope you all understand headphone and microphone. Now next is UPS. UPS stands for uninterrupted power supply. Okay, a UPS keeps a computer running for a short time even after a power cut. What is the work of UPS? UPS is running with the short term when the electricity will gone. Okay, when the light is gone, then and computer, the UPS work for a short time. Is that clear? UPS is used only with desktop computers. Okay, desktop is UPS is only for desktop, not for laptop, smartphone. Is that clear? Now turn next page, come to page number 18. Hard disk. Look this picture. This is a hard disk. Whatever you save in a computer, it gets automatically stored in its hard disk. Whatever you have write in the computer, you will save that point in the computer it will automatically stored in hard disk also. A hard disk is like a small box inside the CPU cabinet. A hard disk can store a large amount of data. Okay, beta. So this is a hard disk. This look like a box, and it will inside the cabinet box, that is CPU. Is that clear? You can store large amount of data, unlimited data you can stored in the hard disk. Now next is CD, DVD and pen drive. CD, DVD and pen drives are used to store a lot of information. These devices are also used to transfer data from one computer to another. Okay. So CD, DVD and pen drive is stored lots of information. Okay. And this device is transfer the data from one computer to the another computer. These devices are easy to carry due to their small size. We can carry these things and we can move from one side to another side. Pen drive is a very small device. It is also known as flash drive. Pen drive, see, this is a pen drive. It is a very small device and it is also known as a flash drive. This is CD, this is DVD and this is pen drive. Is that clear? See, this is a pen drive. It is very small and we can take this and move from one place to another very easily. Is that clear? So students, whatever we have stored in the CD, DVD and pen drive, we can we can transfer the data from one place to another. We can use from one computer to the another computer also. Is that clear? So I hope you all have understood very well this chapter. So today lesson 2 explanation part will completed. Now tomorrow we will start exercises. Okay, so that's all for today. Have a nice day. Bye bye.